Equity markets seldom ignore growth slowdown in a balance sheet. But for Bajaj Finance, the stock markets chose to do just that. So what are the reasons? Hello, my name is Clifford Alvarez and you are watching the Mark to Market show. The Mark to Market column brings you analysis and insights into economics, market moving trends and stocks. Today we will discuss why the Bajaj Finance shares have gained despite reporting a loan growth slowdown for the fourth consecutive quarter. Now Bajaj Finance has been transparent with its shareholders and investors. The lender had warned about a growth slowdown as early as last year. On January 6th, the company detailed its AUM growth at 35%, whereas its loan growth at about 13%. These are very low growth numbers compared to what the company used to declare in previous quarters. Now on that day, that is the 6th of January, the stock fell about 4%. So in some ways, the stock price already factors in this growth slowdown. Bajaj Finance also told its investors about the hit from the broking firm Carvey. So even the spike in non-performing loans was on expected lines. Now lastly and more importantly, the company reported a net profit growth that beat analyst estimates. This shows that the company has been able to squeeze out profit growth even in a slowdown. Also, the company has improved its net interest income as well as fees and commission income. But even then, investors need to be cautious because the slower growth in new loans would mean that the AUM growth would be slower. Besides, the slowdown could also affect asset quality. Although Bajaj Finance's asset quality is impeccable, investors would also need to watch for any signs of a stress in its asset quality. Surely the pain points are there, but they are well known to the markets. The 5 to 6% growth in its share price could be seen as a reward for the transparency. Also, as we said earlier, the December quarter was the fourth consecutive loan growth slowdown for the company. With this as a backdrop, the shares seem to be expensive. Now, investors will have to watch for any slippages in loan growth as well as asset quality. That's all from me for now. Thank you for watching.